సో ఫార్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ ద సింగిల్ లిసింగ్ సిస్టమ్, ద డిజైన్ క్రైటీరియా ఆఫ్ సింగిల్ లిసింగ్ సిస్టమ్, ఇట్స్ డిజైన్ ప్రొసీడ్యూర్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఇన్ అర్లియర్ లెక్చర్. టుడే విల్ బి డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ద డబుల్ లిసింగ్ సిస్టమ్ అండ్ విల్ సీ హౌ టు డిజైన్ ద డబుల్ లిసింగ్ సిస్టమ్. ద డిజైన్ ప్రొసీడ్యూర్ విల్ బి మోర్ ఆర్ లెస్ సిమిలర్ ఎక్సెప్ట్ ద సర్టన్ కన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద లెసింగ్ లైక్ వాట్ విల్ బి ద స్పేసింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద లెసింగ్ దట్ విల్ బి డిసైడెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద దట్ కన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సింగిల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్. అండ్ డబుల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఈజ్ యూస్డ్ వెన్ ద ఈజ్ యూస్డ్ వెన్ వీ నీడ్ లెస్ స్పేసింగ్ బిట్వీన్ టూ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ రిక్వైర్డ్ వెన్ ద మెయిన్ కాంప్రెషన్ మెంబర్స్ ఆర్ వీక్ ఇన్ ఏ సర్టన్ డిరెక్షన్ మీన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ జైరేషన్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ. సో ఇఫ్ ద స్లెండర్నెస్ రేషియో ఆఫ్ ఏ సర్టన్ మెంబర్ ఈజ్ వెరీ వీక్ ఇన్ ఏ డైరెక్షన్ దెన్ సమ్టైమ్స్ వీ నీడ్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ వెరీ ఫైన్ స్పేసింగ్ బిట్వీన్ టూ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్స్ అండ్ ఇన్ దట్ కేస్ వీ గో ఫర్ డబుల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్ విత్ లైటర్ మెంబర్ అండ్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ డబుల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ యూజ్ ఫ్లాట్ బార్ ఫ్లాట్ ప్లేట్ బార్ వీ కెన్ యూజ్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ వీ కెన్ యూజ్ లైట్ ఛానల్ సెక్షన్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ యూజ్ ద ట్యూబులర్ సెక్షన్. నౌ ఫస్ట్ ఐ విల్ గో త్రూ వన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ టుడే విత్ ద బేసిస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ డబుల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్. ఆల్సో ఇన్ దిస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ విల్ సీ దట్ ఈఫ్ ద యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ సే ఫోర్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ దెన్ హౌ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ద సెక్షనల్ ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ద యాంగిల్ హౌ టు మేక్ ద స్పేసింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద యాంగిల్ అండ్ దెన్ ద లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్స్ రైట్. సో లెట్ అస్ గో త్రూ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్. హియర్ యూ కెన్ సీ దట్ ఇన్ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యూ కెన్ సీ దట్ డిజైన్ ఏ బిల్ట్ అప్ డబుల్ లేస్డ్ కాలమ్ విత్ ఫోర్ యాంగిల్స్ టు సపోర్ట్ అన్ ఎక్సెల్ లోడ్ ఆఫ్ 800 kN. నౌ ద కాలమ్ ఈజ్ 14 meters లాంగ్ అండ్ బోత్ ఎండ్స్ ఆర్ ఫిక్స్డ్ అస్యూమ్ Fe410 గ్రేట్ స్టీల్. సో వాట్ వీ నీడ్ టు డూ వన్ థింగ్ ఈజ్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ డబుల్ లెసింగ్ సిస్టమ్ విచ్ హెస్ బీన్ టోల్డ్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఫోర్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్ టు మేక్ ద బిల్ట్అప్ సెక్షన్ అండ్ దిస్ బిల్ట్అప్ సెక్షన్స్ హెస్ బీన్ షోన్ హియర్ విచ్ విల్ బీ మేకింగ్ ఎజ్ ఎ బాక్స్ సెక్షన్. సో ఫోర్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ ఈక్వల్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్ ఫోర్ యాంగిల్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆర్ ప్రొవైడెడ్. నౌ ఫర్ డిజైనింగ్ ఫస్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు నో what should be the angle size, that means section size, and what should be the spacing between the two angles, and what should be the spacing in this direction. So these things first we have to discuss, and then we will go for the lacing system. Now, as we know, the column sections are fixed in both ends. So the effective length you can calculate as 0.65L as per the chordal provision. So the effective length will be 0.65 into 14, which will be 9.1 meters, and axial compressive load was given as 800 kN. So from this we can find out the required area. Required area we can find out by assuming certain permissible stress. So if we assume the permissible design stress as 150 MPa, then required area we can find out from this, that is 800 × 10³/150, which will be 5333 mm². So to get this required area we can provide four angle sections, because each angle sections are having cross sectional area as this. If we consider ISA 90/90/8, if we look through the SP6, we can find out the ISA 90/90/8 is having 1379 mm² cross section area. So required area can be satisfied from this. And the other property which will be required is the center of gravity distance, CG distance, that is 25.1 mm, which will be CZZ is equal to CYY because it is an equal angle section. Similarly, the radius of gyration about ZZ axis and about YY axis will be same, that is 27.5 mm, and moment of inertia IZZ which will be equal to IYY, that is also given as 104.2 × 10⁴ mm². So, the total area we can find out now, that will be total area, cross sectional area will be 4 into 1379 millimeter square, which will become 5516 millimeter square, right. So, if we have this total area, because actually we are providing ISA 90/90/8. So, if we provide 4 numbers of this ISA section, then actual area we are getting this. So, if we have actual area this, then what will be the FCD value, required FCD value. So, from this required FCD value we can find out. So, FCD value will be the 800 is the load by actual area, which is coming 5516. So, I can find out 145.03 MPa, right. Now, if FCD is this, that required FCD is this, then what should be the slenderness ratio, means corresponding to this FCD value we have to find out slenderness ratio, and this can be found from table 9C, because we are providing built up section. So, for that buckling class will be C, and in table 9C we can find out the value for, say, if you use FY 250 grade of steel, then we can find out for FCD is equal to 145.03, I can find out the L by R ratio, that will be 74.36. So, required L by R ratio we can find out as 74.36, which will produce this FCD, right. Now, we know the effective length for column was 9.1 effective length, but if we use as a lacing member, then its increase effective length will be increased by 5%. So, 1.05 into 9.1. So, this will be around 9.5 meter, right. So, effective length, if it is required this, then I can find out what it will be the value of R, because L by R ratio we know, effective length we know. So, R value we can find out as 9.5 meter L into 10 cube to make it millimeter, by L by R ratio is 74.36. So, this is becoming 127.76 millimeter. So, required R, the radius of gyration of the section should have this value, right. So, if required R is this, then we can say that required moment of inertia I is equal to A r square. Now, A is fixed, A already we have fixed as 5516, because the section size is fixed, only the spacing between section size is not fixed. So, into 127.76 square, okay. So, 90.03 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. So, this is the required moment of inertia about II or ZZ. YY and ZZ. So, if we see the section, say for example, this is the 4 angles placed to make the box section, box type section, built up section, right. So, we will provide the spacing between this angle section in such a way that the moment of inertia about both the sections will be same, right. This will be the spacing. So, spacing between these two should be same, so that moment of inertia become same. So, I z z and I y y has to be equal to same, means that will be 90.03 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the. So, I z z and I y y, we have to achieve this value, Okay. So this can be achieved if we make a particular spacing. Say if this is, say if we make say z distance z bar, right, if z bar, and if the C g distance of angle, if I write this is C y y, if I say, then I can write spacing between two angles, S will be 2 into z bar plus C y y, right. So, the spacing between two angles in both the direction has to be z bar plus C y y into 2. Now, to find out z bar, we can find out the means we can equate the I z z and I y y. So, if we equate the I z z and I y y, we can write 90.03, which is the moment of inertia that I can make. So, if I calculate the moment of inertia about this and if I transfer to this distance means in this axis, then I can get that is as 4 angle sections are there. So, 4 into 10, 4 into 2, this is the I section means I moment of inertia of individual section, then plus a r square, a is 5516 into r means here z bar square, right. So, there is 4 sections. So, we have total area is this. So, from this if I equate, I can find out z bar as 124.76 millimeter, right. So, if I get z bar, then I can find out the spacing. So, spacing will be 2 into 124.76 plus 25.1 is the C y y. So, if I make this, I can get the S value as 299.72 millimeter. That means, I can make 300 spacing, right. So, spacing between the angles, I can make 300, so that the required amount of moment of inertia I can achieve in both the direction, because I am going to find out the spacing between two members as 300 mm, and this spacing I am going to find out in such a way that the moment of inertia about y axis and moment of inertia about z axis will be equal, and that will be the required area, that is 90.03 into 10 to the 6. So, once I get this, I can now find out the actual I z z or I y y, right. So, that can be found from this equation. This will be the actual one, 10 to the 4 plus 5516, because I am providing 300 spacing, right. So, if I calculate, it will be actual moment of inertia will be 90.22 into 10 to the 6 millimeter to the 4. This is slightly higher than the earlier one, 90.03, because the spacing what we got actually 299.7, we are providing 300. That is why as we are providing little higher, so I z z or I y y is becoming little higher. And so, actual R we can find out I by A, 90.22 into 10 to the 6 by A is 5516. So, this will become 127.9 millimeter. So, L by R, the slenderness ratio I can find out. L we found earlier, that is 9.5 meter by 127.9. So, this will become 74.28. So, slenderness ratio, actual slenderness ratio we can find from this. Now, from table 9C, I can find out the actual FCD. Earlier we got the required FCD. Now, from the actual dimension, actual spacing of the members, we can find out the design compressive stress FCD as 152 minus 136. This can be found from table 9C, corresponding to L by R as 70 it is 152 and as 80 it is 136. So, if we interpolate we can find out the FCD value as 145.15 MPa. So, capacity of the built up section, the actual capacity I can find out now, the area was 5516 and the FCD value was 145.15. So, it will be Newton. So, it is coming 800.65 kilonewton, right, 800.65 kilonewton, which is slightly less than 800 kilonewton, right. So, it is ok. So, what we have seen that the actual capacity of the built up column has been found on the basis of the spacing whatever we have provided, and from that we have seen that it is slightly higher than the external load 800 kilonewton. However, this can be increased if we increase the spacing between the members in both the direction. If we increase the spacing, then I can increase this, right. Now, I will go to the connecting system. So, in first part what we have seen that we could find the section size of the angle and then the spacing between two members, two angles in z direction and y direction, and spacing has been made in such a way that moment of inertia in both the direction becomes same. So, that the equal resistance of the column can be achieved, and the spacing has been made in such a way that the strength of the member becomes more than the actual one. Now, we will go to the connecting system, that is double lacing system, how to provide the double lacing system and its connections, right. So, for connecting system if we use double lacing, then we can see that if we have two columns and if we provide double lacing here, say like this. So, the spacing between two lacing member will become L 0. Now, if you remember the for single lacing system the spacing was like this, because if I provide single lacing system it is something like this, right. So, the spacing between two system was this. Now, to resist the buckling about the column locally, sometimes we provide double lacing to reduce the effective length between this member. So, in place of single lacing if the length is L, then in place of double lacing length will become L by 2. So, that is why to reduce the effective length we provide double lacing. Now, let us provide double lacing with an angle of 45 degree. So, theta we are assuming as 45 degree. So, if we do so, and for both the cases we are assuming 45 degree, then we can find out the value of L 0. So, if this is x, if I consider, then I can write x by L 0 is equal to tan theta. So, L 0 will become x cot theta, and x is basically 300 was the distance, that is s, this is 300. So, 300 minus 45 minus 45 to get from the bolt distance, okay, to get the value of x from bolt to bolt, right. So, into cot 45 degree. So, this is becoming 210 millimeter. So, spacing between lacing members is achieved as 210 millimeter. Now, L 0 by R y y, this is becoming, so 210 by 27.5. So, this is becoming 7.64, which should be less than 50 and should be less than 0.7 into L by R, that is 0.7 into
L by R was 74.28, we calculated. So, this is 52. So, what we see that L 0 by R y y, we got 7.64, which is less than 50, and 0.7 L by R y, that is 52. So, this is ok. So, length of lacing member is ok means the assumptions of theta, the inclination angle, whatever you have considered is ok. Now, shear force. So, shear force we know that is 2.5% of the axial force will be the shear. So, 2.5% of 800. So, this will be the shear force 20,000 Newton. So, transverse shear in each panel, it will be V by N. So, it will be 2000 by 2. So, 10,000 Newton. So, in each panel the transverse shear is coming this, and as double lacing is provided. So, compressive force will be V by 2 n cosec theta, right. Compressive force, that the member taking the compressive force, say if we call this as compressive force say F, then F is equal to V by 2 n cosec theta, right. So, if I put those value, this is 20,000 by 2 n is 2 into cosec theta means cosec 45 degree, right. So, this is coming 7071 Newton, right. So, compressive force in lacing member we can find. Now, I have to find out the length of the lacing plate. So, to find out length of lacing plate and the depth width of the lacing plate, we have to use certain connection. So, that can be found that whether we are going to use the weld connections or bolt connections. So, there is two options. In this case, let us assume 20 mm diameter grade of 20 mm diameter of bolt of 4.6 grade we are using. So, if we use 20 mm diameter of bolt, then the minimum flat width will be, minimum width B will be 3 D. So, 3 into 20, that is 60 mm. This is given in clause 7.6.2, from where we can find out that minimum width is 60. And length will become, length if I see, this is the length. So, if I have to find out the length, then I know this value is x. So, if this is x, then and this is theta, then x by L is equal to sin theta. So, L is equal to x cosec theta, and x will be 300 minus 45 minus 45 into cosec 45. So, from this I can find out 297 mm. So, length of the lacing plate is 297 mm, and the thickness I can find out as 297 means L by 60. So, 297 by 60. So, this is coming 4.95. So, we can provide a flat size of, means the lacing size of say 297 by 60 say 6. So, this will be the size of the lacing plate. Now, we have to check from radius of gyration point of view, because this lacing plate may buckle. So, whether it is below the permissible radius of gyration or not, or below the permissible slenderness ratio or not, that we have to check. So, slenderness ratio we know, to find out slenderness ratio, first we have to find out the radius of gyration, which is r for rectangular section. We know r is equal to t by root over 12. So, So, t we have considered 6 and this is root 12. So, 1.73. So, I can find out the slenderness ratio, that will be 0.7 into 297.7 L by R, R is 1.73. So, this is becoming 120, which is less than 145. So, okay. So, from slenderness ratio point of view, the size of the lacing member whatever we have considered is okay. So, this is how we fix the size of the lacing bar. However, we have to find out whether the lacing bar is capable of taking tensile strength and compressive strength. In the lacing bar, tensile strength will develop. So, we have to check the developed tensile strength whether the lacing bar can take care or not. So, for L 1 by R means 120, and actually this is 120.2, L 1 by R is 120.2. So, and F y is equal to 250 from table 9 C, I can find out F C D value. F C D value will become 83.7 minus 74.3 by 10 into 0.2. So, that is becoming 83.5 MPa. So, capacity of lacing bar, I can find out capacity will be 83.5 into F C D into 60 into 6, that is becoming 30060, which is greater than the actual force coming into the member, right. So, the compressive strength of the lacing bar is coming 30060 Newton, and the external force in the lacing bar is coming 7071 Newton. So, this is more than the developed one. So, it is okay. So, this is safe. So, from compressive point of view, the members are safe. Similarly, for tensile strength of point of view, we can find out the TDN value, that will be 0.09 into B 60 minus D 20 mm diameter bar we have considered, 20 mm diameter bolt we have considered. So, bolt hole will be 22 into thickness is 6 into Fu by 1.25 gamma m 1. So, if I put this value, I will get 67.3 kilo Newton, and strength due to gross yielding TDG, I can find out, that will be AG Fy by gamma m 0 is equal to 60 into 6 into 250 by 1.1. So, 81.82 kilo Newton, right. So, tensile strength of lacing plate will become lesser of these two, that means 67.3 kilo Newton, and this 67.3 kilo Newton is higher than the 7.071 kilo Newton, which was the force coming on the lacing member. So, from the force point of view, the lacing member whatever we have chosen is okay. Now, very quickly I will discuss about the connection, because connections already we have discussed earlier. Right. So, in case of connections, I will just give an overview, because we know how to do connections. Only difference will be in case of double lacing, if we overlap the lacing system, then it will be double shear. Okay. So, in case of double shear, the strength of the 20 mm diameter bolt can be found, and that will be 2 into 245 into this. So, 90.528 kilo Newton, and strength in bearing also can be found. To find the strength in bearing, we have to find first the value of KB, and KB we know the smaller of this 3, 4. So, one is E by 3 d 0 which is going 0.53 and P by 3 d 0 minus 0.25. Here E we are assuming as 1.5 d 0. So, greater than that. So, we are assuming simply 35 and P we are assuming 2.5 d as 50. So, this is what we are getting, and FUB by FU we get 0.98 and 1. So, smaller of this will be KB value will be finally KB is equal to 0.51,
right.
So, after getting this KB value, we can find out the value of bearing strength. So, strength in bearing I can find from this, if we put the value 2.5 KB, D is 20, T is 6, then FU by gamma MB. So, 50.184 kilo Newton. So, the strength of bolt will be lesser of these two bearing and due to shearing double shear. So, that is coming 50.18 kilo Newton. So, number of bolts I can find out, number of bolts will be actually if we consider as overlapping the lacing, then forces will come from this and from this, if I consider this like this and if we overlap this, then force in compression are coming. So, if we add this, then we will get 2 into that F cot 45 degree, that is the force coming and this is the bolt value. So, 0.28, that means one number of 20 mm diameter bolt is sufficient to carry this load. So, this is what we can find out. Now, we will go to tie plate design. So, tie plate also will be designed similar way what we did earlier. Effective depth we can find out, effective depth will be 300 minus, that is 300 minus 2 into C y y. So, 249.8 and that is more than 2 b. So, it is ok. Overall depth of the tie plate we can find out. Now, depth plus 2 into E, edge distance, because overall depth will be this in case of tie plate. If we have bolt, actually one bolt is there. So, if we have bolt, then the E distance from here we have to find out. So, overall depth of tie plate will be 249 plus 2 into E, right. Then length of tie plate. So, this is what length of tie plate we can find out, that is 300 millimeter. Then thickness of tie plate, thickness of tie plate also we can find out, that is 1/50th of the inner distance of the bolt. So, that we can find out 4.2, we can consider in place of 4.2 say 6 mm. So, we can provide a tie plate of 300 by 320 by 6 mm at both the end, right, with bolt. So, tie plate design is over. Now, we can show in the drawing. So, whatever we have considered in the design and whatever outcome was obtained, that has been written here. Like the spacing between two members are given outer to outer 300 and is a box section and section size is 90 by 90 by 8 and similarly, tie plate size we have considered 320 by 6 mm. And the lacing plate we have considered 60 mm breadth and 6 mm thickness, and the distance between two lacing we have considered this, right. So, this is all about the design of a compression member using double lacing system. So, in this lecture, in short, if we tell that we have understood how to find out the
appropriate section of the angle to withstand that given load, then how to find out the distance between two angles, that is spacing in both the direction to withstand that much load, and then how to design a lacing system using double lacing, right. So, this is all about the lacing system. In next class, we will discuss about the batten system. Thank you.